A warm welcome to all my students. Today, let us tell you about advent of Europeans to India. In this chapter, we will learn about the trade and commerce relationship India had with Europeans, the arrival of Europeans to India for trade, the Carnatic Wars in the backdrop of European political developments, Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar, and dual government system, and the British policy of aggression. So already we had completed two topics in the previous session, and those were the trade and commerce relationship India had with Europeans. And the next one, the arrival of Europeans to India for trade. So these are the two topics we have completed in the previous class. And today's class, today's session, we will learn about Carnatic War, three Carnatic War we are going to learn this in the session, children. Before starting with the three Carnatic War, let we learn what we had learned in the previous session. Let we revise it once. So first in that we learned about the Europeans had a trade with India from ancient time, and Indian spices had great demand. In 1453, the Constantinople was captured by Ottoman Turk, and due to that the Europeans were forced to find a new sea route to India, and Portugal was the first country to discover a new sea route to India. Vasco da Gama succeeded in discovering a new sea route to India. So it was Portugal was the first European country to discover a new sea route and reached near Calicut. After Vasco da Gama, it was Almeida who came to India, and he established or he implemented a new policy, and that was blue water policy. He wanted to establish the supremacy over the sea. After him, Alfonso de Albuquerque, he came to India, and he was a real founder of Portugal. He fought a battle with Sultan of Bijapur in 1510 and captured Goa. Goa became the administrative center of Portugal. Portugal had absolute monopoly over trade with India for almost a century, and their power declined with the arrival of English and French in India. Next, Dutch. Dutch are from Holland or Netherlands. They established United East India Company in 1602. And they established warehouse in Surat, Cochin, Nagapattinam, Machilipattinam and Sinsora. They broke the monopoly of Portugal in India, later unable to face the competition from English and French. The Dutch limited themselves to spice-rich islands. Next, English. In 1600, December 31st, East India Company took the permission from Queen Elizabeth and established a trade with Eastern country for 15 years. The Mughal Emperor Jahangir issued a royal permission to English to establish their first warehouse factory at Surat. Sir Thomas Rowe arrived at the court of Jahangir as a royal ambassador from the court of James I. Next, Madras. English took Madras from the King of Chandragiri and established a strong fort named Saint George Fort. Later, Charles II, the Prince of England, gave Bombay as an annual rent of £10 a year to East India Company in 1668. By 17th century, English had established Bombay, Madras, Calcutta as the center of their presidency, and by the 18th century, English made Calcutta as their capital, implemented their own civil and criminal procedure codes in the area where those were under their control, whichever place was under their control. Next, it was the French. So the four European powers who came to India was Portuguese, Dutch, English, and last one was the French. The French East India Company started as a government-owned company in 1664. It started the first factory in Surat in the year 1668 and established factories in different places like Chandranagar, Karaikal, Mahe. These are the places. And the French took Valikandapuram from a local Muslim official and developed it as a major trade center. That center is located in Pondicherry, and Pondicherry became the administrative center of the French. Dupleix, who arrived in Pondicherry as a governor of France, had the ambition of establishing French as a major power in South India. So this is what we have learned in the previous session. As I told you, Portuguese and Dutch were not able to face the English and the French. They had left India. Now two European powers are existing in India, are the French and the English. The competition between English and the French. Portuguese and Dutch had withdrawn from India, unable to withstand the competition from French and English by 18th century. Finally, French and English restored to show the strength in order to establish their political supremacy over India. Meanwhile, in the region of Hyderabad and Karnataka is located in the eastern part of Tamil Nadu, and both English and French tried to exploit the situation in their favor. This led to three Carnatic wars. Portuguese and the Dutch were not able to withstand the competition of French and English. They left India. English and Portuguese tried to strengthen their political supremacy over India. Mainly, they concentrated in the region of Hyderabad and Karnataka. They tried to exploit the situation and take the benefit out of these situations. That was their main intention, and this led to three Carnatic wars. Hyderabad Kingdom was established in 1724 by Asif Jah. His feudatory ruler, Dost Ali, who was ruling Carnatic region, was not loyal to him. Maratha killed Dost Ali and looted Carnatic and imprisoned his son-in-law Chanda Sahib in Satara. Asif Jah named Anwaruddin as a Nawab of Carnatic in the place of Dost Ali. So first I'm explaining about Hyderabad Kingdom, children. I'm explaining about the Hyderabad Kingdom. And Hyderabad Kingdom was ruled by Asif Jah in the year 1724. Dost Ali was feudatory ruler. That means he has to pay tax to Asif Jah. As he was not loyal to Asif Jah, later he was killed by Maratha. And the Maratha will loot all the wealth from Carnatic as well as imprison his son-in-law Chanda Sahib in Satara. And Asif Jah named Anwardhan as the next Nawab of Carnatic. So remember here, Hyderabad Kingdom was ruled by Asif Jah in the year 1724. Dostari was a feudatory ruler of Carnatic. He was not loyal to Asif Jah. Later, he was killed by Maratha and looted, and his son-in-law was imprisoned in Satara. His son-in-law was Chanda Sahib. Asif Jah named Anwardhan as the Nawab of Carnatic in the place of Dostari. So remember, Asif Jah, the ruler of Hyderabad Kingdom, and next one is Dostari, who was killed by the Maratha, and Anwardhan became the next Nawab of Carnatic. Now, this is a map of Hyderabad here, and here the Carnatic children. That is the eastern part of Tamil Nadu. Now we will learn about three Carnatic warriors. The first Carnatic war took place in the year 1746 to 1748. First remember the date. I am talking about the first Carnatic war, which took place in the year 1746 to 1748. On the request of Dupleix, La Bondarnes, a French military leader from Mauritius, invaded Madras and captured it. This forced the helpless British to request help of Anwardhan, the Carnatic ruler, for the support. The army sent by Anwardhan failed to defeat the French at Madras. Finally, La Bondarnes took money from the English and returned Madras and went back to Mauritius. This enraged Dupleix and attempted to take Madras but failed in it. Finally, the war ended the treaty in Europe between France and England called Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle. So this is the end of first Carnatic war. So in the beginning itself I told you Dupleix was an ambitious man and he decided to expand his kingdom in South India. So on his request, that is Dupleix's request, La Bondarnes, who was a military leader from Mauritius, he invaded Madras and captured it. So remember, Dupleix will call La Bondarnes and ask him to capture Madras. And the British will request Anwardhan to support them. But Anwardhan's army failed and La Bondarnes, he will take the money from the English and return Madras to the English and went back to Mauritius. So remember, first, the English will take the help of Anwardhan, and as Anwardhan army was not able to defeat the French army, that means French defeated Anwardhan army. And finally, English gave some money to La Bondarnes and took Madras from him and he went back to Mauritius. This angered Dupleix and he will make an attempt to capture Madras, but he will fail. In the meantime, a treaty was signed between the France and England in Europe, and that treaty was Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle. So remember, three names you have to remember here: Dupleix, La Bondanus, and Anwarden. On the request of Dupleix, La Bondanus, who was a military leader, he will come from Mauritius, invade Madras, and capture it. And British takes the help of Anwarden to recapture Madras, but Anwarden army was defeated by the French. Finally, La Bondanus took some money from the English and gave Madras, and he went back to Mauritius. This angers Dupleix, and he makes attempt to recapture Madras, but he will fail. In the meantime, a treaty was signed between the France and England in Europe, and that treaty was Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle, and this lead to the end of First Carnatic War. Now here is a picture of Dupleix, La Bondanus, and Anwarden. These are the three names you have to remember in the First Carnatic War. While explaining the First Carnatic War, remember these names and it becomes very easy for you to explain about the First Carnatic War. Dupleix, La Bondanus, and the next last one is Anwarden. Before starting with the Second Carnatic War, we will learn what is the situation in Carnatic and Hyderabad. The Nizam of Hyderabad, Asif Jah, died in the year 1748. A tussle started between his son. His son here is Asif Jah. I'm talking about son of Asif Jah was Nazir Jung. And his here it is Asif Jah's daughter's son, Musafir Jung. These two were fighting for the throne. That is, Nazir Jung and Musafir Jung will tussle for the succession of the throne. On the other hand, here I am talking about Carnatic children. This para is talking about the Carnatic here. On the other hand, a fight had broken between Chanda Sahib, who was released by the Maratha, who was in the prison. He was released by the Maratha. Between Chanda Sahib and Anwarden in Carnatic. In Carnatic, two people are fighting. That is, one is Chanda Sahib and the other one is Anwarden. Now here if you see, one side the French is supporting Musafir Jung in Hyderabad and Chanda Sahib in Carnatic. Remember, French is supporting two people, one person in Hyderabad, the other person in Carnatic. So here you have to remember Musafir Jung in Hyderabad and Chanda Sahib in Carnatic. The spelling of Carnatic is wrong. Please correct it here. It is C-A-R-N-A-T-I-C. Carnatic. In 1749, the combined force of Chanda Sahib and Musafir Jung defeated Anwarden. Anwarden is the Nawab of Carnatic, and he was killed. He was killed in the Ambur battle. This is the end of Anwarden. Anwarden was killed in Ambur battle. It was a combined force who fought against him. It was French, Chanda Sahib and Musafir Jung. The three were joined together and defeat Anwarden, and he was killed in the Ambur battle. As a result, Chanda Sahib becomes the next ruler of Carnatic. Muhammad Ali, the son of Anwarden, stayed at Trichinopoly with the help of English. So after the death of Anwarden, his son took the help of English and he stayed at Tiruchirappalli. Next, in Hyderabad, Musafir Jung became the Nizam by killing Nazir Jung. Nazir Jung is the son of Asif Jah. He was killed by Musafir Jung. So in Hyderabad, Musafir Jung becomes the next Nizam. After a few days, Musafir Jung got killed. So remember children, in Hyderabad when we talk, first you have to remember Asif Jah. After Asif Jah, there was a tussle between Nazir Jung and Musafir Jung. And finally in that, Nazir Jung was killed and Musafir Jung becomes the next Nizam. And later, after few days, Musafir Jung was killed. And the French made Salbat Jung, another son of Asif Jah, as a Nizam of Hyderabad. Second Carnatic War took place in the year 1749 to 1754. In the changed circumstance, French made Salbat Jung, another son of Asif Jah, as a Nizam of Hyderabad. An officer named Bushi was stationed in Hyderabad for his protection by French. In Carnatic, Chanda Sahib, the Nawab with the help of French, Robert Clive of the East India Company attacked Arka and the capital city of Carnatic and defeated Chanda Sahib. So first we will start with Salbat Jung, who was another son of Asif Jah. He was a Nizam of Hyderabad. For his protection, Bushi stayed in Hyderabad. In Carnatic, Chanda Sahib became the Nawab of Carnatic and he was supported by French. Robert Clive, the East India Company, attacked Arcot and the capital city of Carnatic and defeated Chanda Sahib. Chanda Sahib was imprisoned and later killed in this war. In the place of Chanda Sahib, English named Muhammad Ali, the son of Anwaruddin, as a Nawab, the English extended their support, Nazir Jung and Anwaruddin. The Second Carnatic War ended with the Treaty of Pondicherry. The French recalled Dupleix and this war brought laurel to English while French suffered a political setback. So first we learnt about Hyderabad children. In Second Carnatic War, you have to divide into two. One, you will explain about Hyderabad and the second, you will explain about Carnatic. Carnatic, first we will learn about the Hyderabad. Hyderabad was ruled by Salbat Jung, who was a son of Asif Jah and he was protected by the French. So, in Hyderabad, the French dominated there. Next, we will learn about Carnatic. Carnatic was ruled by Chanda Sahib, who was supported by the English. Robert Clive defeated Chanda Sahib, imprisoned him, later killed in the war. English declares Muhammad Ali, who is the son of Anwaruddin, as the Nawab of Carnatic. this is the end of Second Carnatic War. And the Second Carnatic War comes to an end with the Treaty of Pondicherry. And French underwent a loss due to that Dupleix was called back. And French suffered a political setback. So this is the end of Second Carnatic War. The Third Carnatic War, which took place in the year 1756 to 1763. County Lally of French attempt to besiege Vandywash in 1760. In this decisive battle, Sir Ayacuche of the English army defeated French and imprisoned Bushy. Lally escaped and hid in Pondicherry. When we learn about the Third Carnatic War, you will also learn about the Battle of Vandywash, which took place in the year in 1760 between County Lally and Sir Ayacuche. And in this, Sir Ayacuche won the battle and the French lost the battle. Bushy was imprisoned, Lally escaped and hid in Pondicherry. Finally, Sir Ayacuche attacked Pondicherry. Lally had to surrender unconditionally in 1761. The French had to lose all their base in India due to Carnatic War. In spite of this, as per the Treaty of Paris in 1763, Pondicherry was written to French. With these developments, French lost their importance in India. Like this, English, by defeating all their rivals, and started consolidating their power over the southern India. Finally, French had to lose all their base in India. In spite of this, as per the Treaty of Paris, Pondicherry was written to French. English was able to consolidate their power in southern India. This is the picture of Sir Ayacuche Bushy, who played a very important role in Third Carnatic War. Assignment. First question, why did Carnatic War take place? In this, you will write from Portuguese and Dutch withdrawing from India, the French and the English tried to establish their supremacy over India. Meanwhile, a conflict arose in Hyderabad and Carnatic, and both English and French tried to exploit the situation, and this led to the Carnatic War. This is the answer you will write here. And next one is, how did Anwaruddin became the Nawab of Carnatic? You will explain the first Carnatic War, children. And next one is, write a short note on the Second Carnatic War. Here you will explain from the French supporting Hyderabad and Carnatic, who are the people they supported. You will explain about it. And the other side, you will explain about English supporting whom in Hyderabad and in Carnatic. You will explain. And finally, in Hyderabad, who was a ruler, and in Carnatic, who was a ruler, you have to explain. And next one is, when and between whom was the Battle of Vandywash fought? You have to explain about the Third Carnatic War, and you will write Sir Ayacuche and Lally here. Thank you, children. And in the next session, we will discuss about Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar and Dual Government. These are the topic to I will explain in the next session. Thank you, children.